You fire up After Effects, import some files, and dive into creating something amazing. And then, bam! The app decides to fight back. Panels reopening right after you've closed them. Mysterious black frames, dimmed menu, sluggish performance, and those relentless pop-up tips. Oh, what is this chaos and why this is happening? Don't worry, I've got your back. Let me show you how to tame these pesky After Effects quirks and get back to creating in peace. So to demonstrate all of those quirks, I'll use this project that I revived from my archive. I created it 5 years ago, maybe even more, and I think it still holds. And I'll pause the playback and select the 5 logo layer. And this brings up, of course, the properties panel, as well as this really annoying coach marks. For the time being, I'll click OK and I'll save this one for later. Let's talk about the properties panel. Some of you really loved it. I actually created a full tutorial of how to get the most out of it. The link is down below. But from time to time, I'm getting requests from people who doesn't seem to really play along with the properties panel and wants to just switch it off completely. Now, here's the problem. You may think that you can go to the option menu and just close the panel and make it go away. But the next time I'll select another text or shape layer or other layer that uses the properties panel, and let's say that I want to edit this text, so I'll click on the text tool, here it comes again in its full glory. So it didn't go away. It is still part of the interface. So what can I do? Well, the solution is over here. You need to switch off auto open panel, and you'll need to do it for both text and shape layers. And then, it's not enough, you also need to toggle it off by clicking on this icon. And now, if I'll deselect and then reselect the text layer, the properties panel will not show again. So do it either for text or shape layer. So if you're moving to a shape layer, then it will show up again. And this is because these layers has the same options. So you need to tick off the auto open panel, and then you need to toggle back the properties panel. And now all the layers that uses the properties panel are not going to automatically open it again. Now, let me select this pre-comp that has an image sequence of this tennis ball. I'm just going to play it for you over here. I'll close it and I'll preview it again in the main comp. So let's say that we want to speed up the playback of this composition. To do it, I'll make sure the comp is selected, go to the layer menu, and then under time, I'll enable time remapping, which is going to place a keyframe at the beginning and at the end. Now I'll take the last keyframe, which represents, of course, the last frame of this composition, and I'll drag it to the 2 seconds mark because I want to play this faster. Now notice what happens here. Although I'm dragging the last frame, After Effects is showing us nothing. And this is some sort of a bug with the time remap operator. I'm not sure how and why this is happening, but the fix is very simple. All you need to do is move one frame before the last keyframe and then create another keyframe over here. Now, the way to do it is to actually undo the time remapping and make sure that you add additional time remapping keyframe before the last one. And now I'll zoom into the timeline by pressing plus on the keyboard, select the last keyframe that After Effects created automatically, remove it, and then I can zoom back. And then I'll go back to the 2 second mark, move this over here. I'll option click on the stopwatch to add the loop out expression. Then I'll click outside and this is going to fix it for us. So now we are no longer seeing black frames and we have a faster animation or slower animation or whatever you want to do with the time remapping applied to a pre-comp. All right, next I want to take this text layer, which I know for sure. Let me show you, I'll switch to Illustrator. This is where I've created this text. So I know for sure this text is a live type. Now, when I bring it to After Effects, even if I'll right click on the text and choose create, I can convert it to an editable text, which is something that you can do if you bring a Photoshop document. But for some reason, you can't convert AI to live text. So for that, you have 2 solutions. One is to return back to Illustrator and then just copy the text to the clipboard. Then create a new text layer. Command, Option, Shift, T will do it for you. And then paste the text and everything survived, including the leading, the text formatting, the kerning. I'm just going to place it on top of the original one and then I can switch this one off. Alternatively, if you have access to Overload, you can of course do the same from here. So you can select the text and you can push the selection to After Effects. So one of these solutions is going to work for you. And now I can select the text and maybe go to Layer and then under Layer Styles, apply a Drop Shadow just to make it a little bit more pronounced and legible on screen. And I'm also going to sample the purple color and reduce the opacity. But now we have a live text that we can continue to edit and animate. And now to something that happens even to the most experienced After Effects users. You want to create a new layer, you know the keyboard combination, Command Y. I'm pressing the keyboard shortcut and nothing happens. So you go to the menu item and everything is dimmed. And the reason is that, of course, the wrong panel is selected. So After Effects is very sensitive. It's a spoiled application. It wants you to select either the composition or the timeline panel. Now, of course, you can click on that. But since you are here, let me share with you my most used keyboard combination in After Effects, which is the backslash or the pipe key. Clicking on it will activate the timeline. Another click will activate the composition viewer. So regardless of which one of these is selected, you will have access to the commands under the layer menu. And of course, this is also true if you want to apply effects. So now I can go ahead and create a solid text, light, whatever I want, maybe even an adjustment layer. Now, the next issue is quite rare, but it can happen to you and it's very frustrating. And sometimes After Effects will even throw an error message, all because you clicked on Crreate New Comp. I'm going to use whatever I'm seeing over here. Click OK. And then I'm waiting and waiting and waiting and waiting and waiting and...
What is that?
I don't know. I was trying to do something. Oh, well. I guess we're just gonna have to wait.
Finally, After Effects created the new comp for me. Why this is happening? Well, let's go to the composition menu and choose composition settings. And I'll go to the 3D renderer and notice that now I'm using Cinema 4D. Now, this can happen, especially if you are opening After Effects for the first time and left it like this. Every time After Effects is creating a new composition using the Cinema 4D renderer, it needs to communicate with the C4D Lite or Cineware technology that is baked into After Effects. And sometimes it can completely fail to do so. The next time, by the way, you'll open it, it's going to be quite fast. So let me show you first what you need to do. If you get an error message, go ahead to Creative Cloud, locate After Effects and go to the ellipses, the three dots, and then visit the add-ons menu. Make sure that Cinema 4D by Maxon is added. Now, sometimes it won't be added by default, especially if you're upgrading. You may be prompted to install it, and if you didn't notice, then click cancel, then it won't install it by default. And this is a necessary add-on for After Effects to use the Cinema 4D renderer, as well as to install Cinema 4D Lite. So if you can't see this over here, just make sure to add this to After Effects. And once the installation has been finished, quit After Effects, relaunch it, and you will be able to use it as usual. All right, finally, I've got another one for you. I'm going to select the environment light here. And although I switched off the properties panel, here it is again. And the reason is because I forgot to switch off these really annoying coach marks or tips. Now, I guess this is in good intention. After Effects is offering some new information about new tools and things which are changed in the application. But if you are like me and you don't have any use for it, then click OK. Of course, you can switch off or close the properties panel because, again, we don't want to see it, at least not in this tutorial. And then let's go back to the After Effects settings. This will be the Edit Preferences on the Windows side. Head to the General settings and then switch off Enable Coach Marks. and these are not going to bother you anytime again. And that's it. Hopefully, these After Effects ghosts will stop hunting your projects. If you've got other annoyances that needs exercising, drop them down in the comments below. I'm all ears. And hey, if you're up to a trip down memory lane with tools that time forgot, click the link here, somewhere over here in the screen, and I'll see you there for a fun little rant.